Good day, folks. My name is Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in beautiful Eugene, Oregon. RV Corral has been here for over 25 years. Same location, taking care of customers, finding the right rig for the right price, and taking care of them after the sale. We have a wonderful body shop, we have a full parts department, and a service shop as well. This is a recent trade-in I just took in. We haven't cleaned it, we haven't touched it. It's a 2008 Winnebago Tour 40WD. Beautiful coach, 16,000 miles. I've got the generator compartment open up the front just to show you that we've got the upgraded 8K Onan diesel generator. They used to be referred as the quiet diesel. Because with the Winnebago Tour, number one, this doesn't have to deal with the DEF tanks that the 2011s have to, which is an emission thing. But secondly, the Tour is one of the top of the lines for them. Full fiberglass, one-piece roof. We're running the ISL 400 horsepower engine in this puppy, so it can get up and move down the road. Side-mounted cameras, as well as the backup monitor on the inside. Big Alcoa wheels on the outside with the 22.5 tires. Dual fuel fill from either side. We have the awning toppers as well as the power awnings on the exterior of this coach, and this is what they refer to as a full body paint. Look at this storage area we have down here with the slide-out trays, full pass-through. The tray sometimes is referred to as the coffin because it will slide either way, driver's side or passenger side. We have some nice features on the inside, but we'll get to that in a minute. We have a full air ride, full air brake chassis. This is on the Freightliner chassis, 50 amp cord service. And another unique thing with the Tour back in this time frame was we have a residential 2-ton heat pump down in the basement. So what does that do? That eliminates two big roof air conditioners up on top. We have a 10,000 pound tow hitch back here, plus I have a ladder with a ladder extension that's in the storage compartment down below. There we have the backup monitor, and notice we have the tail lights pretty up high in this unit here. We have a gas electric hot water heater, and of course we have the dual furnace. Down here is where I have my 50 amp cord service, and I also have my dual batteries, so I can slide these out on trays. I have a couple for the engine and I have a couple for the house. And in this compartment down here is the center where I can dump my holding tanks. I've got my water filtration system for the entire coach. I have my leveling system right here. Because it's a computerized leveling system, I can level it from inside or I can level it from outside. Sani flush, back flush system, which is pretty much standard this day and age. We have the quick port release, so where if I just tap that down, I can lay my fresh water hose here, or I tap this one down, I can lay my sewer hose, so I don't need to unscrew a compartment to access that. This is just going to be the backside where my 50 amp service is. I do have a vacuum cleaner system built right in, and I am running a 2000 watt inverter in this coach. So this is nothing but accessibility for that big tray that goes either way. And then this compartment right here, I'm going to have my propane tank. And this is a good thing. See all these wiring here with Winnebago? Every 3 inches, that wiring is labeled through the whole coach. Nice thing about that is that if you have an electrical problem, you don't need to pay the service mechanic hours and hours and hours trying to trace down a wire. It's all labeled. It's pretty much something Winnebago has back there in Forest City, Iowa. We are a new Winnebago dealer, and we do carry a lot of their products today. Big chrome mirrors on the outside. But the exciting thing is, folks, the inside floor plan of this Tour is really unique. At this point, if you have a piece of paper and a pen handy, because at the end of this video, you are going to get the information as far as my name, my phone number. And folks, this might be a little bit too big for you. You might be looking for something with a tag axle and a diesel pusher, which I can help you with. We do have several more. Big flat screen TV, very easy to view. These front chairs swivel around. And talking about a bigger coach, folks, that's what these people did. They went to my 45-foot bath and a half, just upgrade a little bit. Smart steering wheel, to where I have my lights, my windshield washers, everything right in here. But look at the way that Winnebago angles, for example, the shifter right here. So it's not sitting flat where it's hard to read. Or down in here, this is where I will find my HWH computerized leveling system. Or the slide outs have locks on them themselves. And here we go, Curtis. Let them take a look at this floor plan. Beautiful. I love the way the table and seating is right across from the kitchen. Very easy to get to for somebody preparing. For example, like you're in here at the kitchen and you're preparing stuff here, it's turn, serve, very easy, very accessible. Radius ceiling, 7 foot high. Fantastic fan in the ceiling. I love these little reading lights right here, or mood lights, whatever you want to call them. Dual pane windows, microwave convection oven, a lot of storage, adjustable shelving on the inside, drawers all over the place, folks. This kitchen is to die for. Fluorescent light up underneath here. And here I have my DVD player, and this is where my satellite dish receiver. We have an automatic dish on the top of the roof on this one. This is in the cherry wood. I do have the build sheet if you're interested in me scanning it, emailing it to you, faxing it to you. I have the ice maker on one side and then the freezer on the other. Big fridge. Super, super clean. Over on this side, I have some nice pantry with pull-out drawers. Very, very functional. Very well thought of floor plan. And big bathroom. Residential stool. Another fantastic fan in the ceiling. The sink is kind of something you would find in like the Hilton. Folks, I hope you're enjoying this video, if you're taking notes. Kind of tight quarters here, but Curtis, our cameraman, does a fantastic job for us. He's going to go back into the bedroom area where we have a one-piece washer dryer. This is a king. It's going to be a Select Comfort mattress. I have day and night shades. Excuse my head there, folks. And so that is where I have my Splendide one-piece washer dryer. And then a nice closet that opens, all my valves for the washer dryer right in here. Now let me see if I can open the other one. The bed's very easy to get around too, folks. So either side, I have the long closet over there. Here's my residential. This is really neat. It's an air filter for my residential heat pump down below. It just gives you so much cleaner air on the inside. And that heat pump will go down to about 36 degrees. And if it gets colder than that, then my residential heaters will kick on. So I've got heat going down into my holding tanks. Got about 8-9 minutes of movie time here. So I really appreciate your patience and going through us with this. My name is Raymond Moore. I'm here with the RV Crowd. Wonderful place to do business. We take care of our customers after the fact, not just during the sale. And we do a really, really good job with the new owner school. So maybe you might be moving up from a gas coach or just getting into a diesel for the first time around. Love to work with you. I want to thank you now for watching this video. Have a great day. Call me, email me, stop by, and we'll have some peppermint tea together. Thanks again, folks. Have a great day.